Hey guys, welcome back. Finally, we have received our OnePlus 6, which is a mirror edition, guys. Today, I received this device, which looks pretty amazing. Here you can see it looks awesome with the notch available and the 18:9 ratio. So first, let me show you the software information, and it comes pre-installed with Oxygen OS 5.1. And here you can see Android version is 8.1 with a security patch of 1st April 2018. But if you go to software update, here you have a software update available, which is 5.1.3, and the size of this is 353 MB. So I won't be upgrading to this directly. I'll be moving on to Android P, which is a developer version and can be found on OnePlus forum. So there are two versions available. One is MP version, which is a stable version, and the second one is the DP version, which is developer preview version, which have few bugs. So guys, if you are trying, try at your own risk, and make sure to take a backup of the entire internal storage, because you need to wipe internal storage to install that firmware. So once you have downloaded, what you need to do is place it inside internal memory. Once you have copied the file inside the internal memory, tap this setting icon towards the right hand side, do a local upgrade and select the file which you have copied. Select this and select install now. So once the process is completed to 100%, then you need to power off your device. Once the device is powered off, hold volume down key and power key together to boot your device into recovery. Once your device is in recovery, then you need to go down and select here wipe data factory reset. So select this option, select yes, and now reboot your device. So now device boots up. I'll complete the initial setup and after that I'll get back to you guys. So after completing the initial setup, first let me show you the software information, going to about phone, and here you can see Android version is Android P with a security patch of 5th May 2018. And guys, there are lots of issues in this build. If you still want to try, you can just give a try, but make sure to take a backup of your internal storage. And to roll back to the previous version, that is 8.1, there's a different file. All the files I'll mention in the description below, you can download from there. And to roll back, you need to unlock your bootloader, or else you won't be able to roll back to the previous build. So if you want to take a risk of unlocking bootloader, then you can try with Android P and give a fresh look to your device. So talking about the change logs, on OnePlus 6, the launcher has still not been updated, which is still 2.3.3. But on OnePlus 5, which is running Android 8.1, the launcher is 2.4. That is the latest launcher available on OnePlus devices. And talking about rest change logs, quick setting tiles has been changed. You can see on OnePlus 5, which is on Android 8.1, and on OnePlus 6, which is running Android P. So now you have a new design for quick settings. And same goes with the power menu. On 8.1, you can see the power menu, and on Android P, this is a power menu which is available. So not much of UI changes. I'll tell you which all things are not working. First of all, you don't have full screen gesture available. So if you go to buttons and gesture, here you have only option to customize the alert slider, and you have a alert slider towards the right hand side on this device. There is no other gesture available, but still if you want, you can just go to the system and here you can find gestures which says swipe up on the home button. So if you open this, it shows you one of the image to swipe up from the home button, but if you try, it does not work, as I have already enabled it. So this thing is also not working. Talking about Volt services, I'm using Jio SIM card on this and Volt services are not working, so you cannot make the calls. Still you can use the data from this SIM. There are slight issues with the Bluetooth also. When I try to pair it with my smartwatch, the Bluetooth gets disconnected in between. Under battery, you can find a battery manager available here. Under display, you don't have much of options. Ambient display is available. You still don't have always on display. You just have lift to check, or else the device will wake up when there is any notification. Under security, you still don't find face unlock feature, but let's check fingerprint sensor whether it works or not. And you can see fingerprint is working ultra fast. There are no issues in the fingerprint on this build. For me, there are no issues in the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is perfectly working fine. Moving on to camera. Camera slow motion is not working. Once you open slow motion, there is nothing appearing on the screen. So slow motion is not working. Rest everything is working on camera. And as per their official forum, they say Widevine L1 does not work. So if you guys are not aware about Widevine, it is used to play high quality videos on Netflix or Amazon Prime. Swiping towards the right hand side opens up shell. So there are not much of changes, just the settings panel has been redesigned and the quick setting panel has been redesigned. So if you guys want to give a try, you can just try it, but I would say you just need to wait for some time, and once if you get the stable version, you can give a try on Android P. But as of now, this is not stable. Many of Indian users are using Jio SIM cards, so they cannot make calls using Jio SIM cards. Not talking about the benchmark results. So I have taken benchmark results on Android 8.1, the previous build which was available on this device, and we'll compare it with this build which I have installed, that is Android P. So going with Geekbench application, and under this single core scores 2477, the same scores were available on Android 8.1. You can check it out towards the left hand side, but multi-core scores little bit low on Android P. Going with AnTuTu Bench application, under this results are 2,77,691, wherein on previous build it was 2,67,154. So there are not much of difference. I'll make a complete review once we have the stable build of Android P for OnePlus 6. So you guys stay tuned for that, and if you have any kind of questions regarding installation or reverting back to the stock, which is Android 8.1, then you can let me know in the comment section below. So as of now, only this much in this video. Hope you like the video, and if you like the video, then do give me a thumbs up. Also, if you are new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe the channel, because I'll be getting new videos on OnePlus 6 from today.